Hi everyone, welcome to the 10th episode of The Secret Letters. As usual, we have a wonderful, wonderful letter to share with you all today. Before that, I have a small message to share with you all. Since the lockdown is slightly relaxed these days and people are getting back to office and few of them have started taking appointments, similarly, we are also getting other schedule filled. So we are really, really tight on a schedule and we are not finding it feasible to come and talk to you all every day. So we will be having these episodes. We're not going to stop, but we are going to have these episodes on alternate days from now on. So I hope you will understand. So we are trying our best to reach out to you and talk to you all and share the stories to you all. But henceforth, it's going to be on alternate days. I hope you will understand. And again, some of you all still have a doubt on how to send or share your stories or your queries or anything. It's pretty easy. There is an email address that is mentioned below. You can send it to us, and if you want to feature your stories, even that can be sent to the same email address that is mentioned below. So let's move on. I hope you have your coffee, tea and green tea or whatever you like right next to you. So today we have a letter that is from a wonderful parent. All the parents are really wonderful. I'm just not saying this particular person, but you know, once you talk to them and you're connected to them, you have that bond that you feel very, very personally connected, right? So that is why I'm referring to them as wonderful parent. Both of them are extremely sweet people. So what do we name them? You know, let's call them as Chocolate and Mint. So Mr. Chocolate and Miss Mint. So it's a letter written by them. When it comes to parenting or childhood issues or teenage issues, we keep it very close to our heart, because if you actually see the videos, we started off talking about parenting and teenage issues. So this is also connected to that, and we want certain things to reach people. So this is very, very important if you are a parent, if you have children, or rather you're a teenager with some kind of issues with parents, it will help you in some way or the other, is what I feel. So this is a very emotional letter that has been written to us, but the good news is we have already dealt with them and now things are sorted and they're very happy. Since as I told you earlier, we are including letters of people who have taken our service and who are actually very happy today, and some of them just write to get answers from us. So this is one of the families who have taken our service and is really happy today. So that is why I'm smiling and that is why I'm sharing with you all with a lot of happiness. So let's go to the letter. If I talk about the family, I can go on and on and on, so let me not go in that direction. I have something to share with you all, so let me go to the letter. So we will start with how Mr. Chocolate and Miss Mint met. Okay, so they are from the same village, and they used to play together. They're childhood buddies. We cannot call them childhood sweethearts, but they were childhood buddies. And they used to play together. They used to attend the festivals together. They used to attend the birthday parties together. So when it's a small place, and if you're more or less of the same age group, you know, slightly 5 years older, 5 years younger, anything doesn't matter. But if you come into the same age group, so you end up being in the same party, same play group, and same friends, you know, you are all together. So that's how they grew up. And while Mr. Chocolate reached his teenage, there is a phase when all of us have that infatuation, that crush, right? So Mr. Chocolate had that infatuation, that kind of a crush, that kind of a feeling, an attraction towards the curly-haired, buck-tooth beauty of ours, that is Miss Mint. So this is a silent admiration, silent feeling towards her, because when you live in a close-knit circle, you cannot just go and express to people about your feelings or what kind of an attraction you have for the other person. So Mr. Chocolate was growing that feeling within himself, and he never expressed it to her. It was a secret thing within him, and they grew up like that. The secret admiration goes on. He used to love to see her curls, he used to love to see her buck-tooth smile. You know, sometimes your imperfections are so beautiful that, you know, like a crooked teeth can look so beautiful and so cute in another person's eyes, right? So similarly, Mr. Chocolate loved her curly hair and her buck tooth. You know, a buck tooth. There are so many people who actually have a complex with the buck tooth, but it can be really beautiful for people who really love you. So he really liked the imperfections in her, and was madly in love with her with time. You know, first it's an attraction, then it's like a crush, and then it is going on to be a love. You know, you can call it a love later on. So he was in love. It's a one-sided love. And this girl is least aware of his feelings, and she's totally into her studies, and she has her own girl gang. She speaks about movies, she used to go to libraries, she used to read a lot. So her life revolved around her girl gang and her interest in chocolates and baking, and she had her own beautiful life. So as time passed by, she was in college, he had finished college, and he started his own ice cream shop. It's a corner shop in the village. The only innovative idea that's there in the village is serving different flavors of ice cream, where the customers had the liberty or the privilege to have their own favorite topping. They could decide on what topping you want. You take a vanilla ice cream, you can have choco chip, you can have probably berries or anything. You can customize your ice cream the way you want. So because of this innovative idea, he had so many people flocking around it. Let it be students, young couples, or let it be grandparents with their grandchildren. There were a lot of people used to come, and he was doing extremely well. So here is this man who's very good looking, very smart, businessman making a lot of money, and he was so spiritual. He was very connected to the people, to his village on the whole. And if there is a wedding, if there is a funeral, if there is a birthday, he's the one who is to go first and give that helping hand. So he had a very good name in the society, and obviously the most of the girls were like crazy on him, because see there are a few factors that actually attracts women, right? Especially young girls who are in almost in their teens or going to their teens. So they are they get carried away by good looks and the gentlemanly image that they create, and another thing is a lot of money. You know, so these things actually attract a lot of women. I mean, young women, all the younger girls. There's another section altogether who would like totally different person. That is, I don't want to talk about it right now, because in this particular letter, it doesn't have a role to play. So this is what. So everybody had most of the girls had a crush on him. So this went on, you know, this secret admiration goes on. There is the feeling that he has for Miss Mint. So as days go by, Mr. Chocolate's father goes and talks to Miss Mint's father, asking for her hand for his son. So both the children are not aware of it, but Mr. Chocolate's dad had an urge to bring her home as a daughter. So he goes and he speaks to Miss Mint's father, and Miss Mint's father is extremely happy. Who wouldn't want such a perfect man for their child? So he is like, okay, we are going for it, we are fine with it. Because at that time, at that point of time, nobody actually asks, ask the children, like, do you want to get married? Are you okay with it? Because the parents decide and the children just follow. So that's what was happening in their village. And the father was extremely happy. And that evening, when Mr. Chocolate came back home, his father breaks the news and says that he has decided to bring home Miss Mint as his daughter-in-law or as his daughter. And Mr. Chocolate actually blushes silently. He's unable to contain his happiness. He doesn't know what to do. He cannot tell his father that he was actually in love with her. And he's really, really happy for his father understanding, you know, or rather choosing the right person for him. So from now onwards, Miss Mint also started reacting to it. She is extremely happy because the entire girl gang had a crush on him. All of them wanted to be, wanted to have him in their dreams. So she was really happy that she actually got someone who is really, really wanted by a lot of other women, you know. So this is also there amongst young girls. Like, what happens is that if someone is like the star, you know, like a lot of people after him, then they would also want to be a part of it, right? So this thing happened, and Miss Mint was again okay. She's got the perfect man, a perfect gentleman. Her father has chosen the right person. So then the romance begins. It is written very beautifully in this letter how everything happens just by glances and the smiles that they exchange, because they do not get opportunity to talk or probably go out. All that was not allowed and it didn't happen for them. So what used to happen is when the clock strikes 4, Mr. Chocolate would just run his hand through his hair, set his hair and run outside and stand outside his shop, because that's when Miss Mint comes back from college along with her friends. So he used to wait for the curly haired beauty and wait to just have a glance from her, just exchange smiles and just go off. So he says, you know, like, you cannot express in words, you cannot just limit it to words what their eyes had to say, what their smile had to say, what their glances had to say. He said that feeling was extremely beautiful. So these glances and smiles were being exchanged, and they had to tell their own stories through these expressions. So this is what happened. And as time went on, she finished her studies and she really scored well with her studies. And her parents call Mr. Chocolate's family home to take a decision on their future, because it was almost a year and a half back that they had spoken about getting them married. So they had planned a meeting around 5 o'clock. So Mr. Chocolate, instead of the 4 o'clock today, at 5 o'clock, he just tried to look his best and goes on to Miss Mint's house. And as he enters Mint's house, that is the first time he's getting to see Miss Mint in that kind of a proximity, you know, like very close. And he is just engulfed. He's gone crazy with the kind of beauty that she had. So, you know, when you are in love and you are containing it for a year and a half without getting any chance or an opportunity to be with that person, it tends to make you feel that she's even more beautiful. So that's what was happening to him. And as they go and sit across the table and have their tea and their snacks, Mr. Chocolate's dad asks Mint, as in, what exactly is her plan? Does she want to study further, or does she want to join some job and start working, or does she want to sit at home? And then he pauses and he says that if the last one is her option, his son wouldn't be that happy, because he doesn't like women sitting idle at home. So what is your choice? Miss Mint says that she wants to help Mr. Chocolate in the business. So once she says that, everyone is extremely happy, because she directly or indirectly said that, you know, she wants to help Mr. Chocolate, and at the same time she did see a point that she was interested in business. So everyone is happy with what the kind of answer she had given. And Mr. Chocolate was even more happy, because he always wanted a woman who would be independent financially and should be in a condition to take decisions on her own. So he just smiles and he says that he has something better in mind. That is, he wishes to start an organic scented candle shop right adjacent to his so that she could manage it. So she was even more happy because she really loved the idea and she was always interested in candles and the delicate things like the perfumed candles or the little glass artifacts. She always loved it. So keeping all that in mind, he came up with the idea to have the scented candle shop for her. So both the families are extremely happy and they decide on going ahead and doing this. He also had a condition that, you know, they would inaugurate the shop and only then later on, probably a week later, they would get married, because it shouldn't be like a clash of priorities. So they decided to start a business for her. So slowly both the families together help them set up the business and they inaugurate the shop amongst their friends and villagers and the spiritual head, and they go ahead with inaugurating the shop and they take the equal responsibility of their business. So within a week's time, as I told you earlier, they get married again with the blessings of their parents and the spiritual head and the friends. They get happily married. So this is a story about Mr. Chocolate, who really wasn't head over heels towards his childhood buddy, Miss Mint, who is unaware of the whole thing, and how they planned their journey ahead and how he wanted to see his woman independent. So all these things was there in the letter that I wanted to include in this particular episode. So we have a lot more to say. You can see that in the next episode.